Very good morning. Yeah, today we are going to be discuss about the concept of data structures. So before talking about the data structures, let us have a discussion about what exactly the importance of data structure and why we should go for using the data structure and how it is related to in our real regular life to solve a problems. Okay, as a part of this data structure, let us have a discussion about what exactly the definition of data structure. Okay, so that is we are going to be see that, and after that, what are the prerequisites in order to specify about the data structure concepts. Okay, so now we are going to be see that what do you mean by data structure. Okay, and data structures. Okay, so whenever we are talking about the data structures, first of all, in our regular life we will use so many places data structure. For example, let us take any particular objects in a particular room. Okay, so different objects is nothing but different type of items we are going to be organizing in as per our according to our usage. Okay, for example, if you take your room, in a room some specific books which are specific to the author and specific to the particular type of a book we are going to be organizing a particular desk. Okay, so like that different objects we can able to organize in different manner, but each and every manner is nothing but one structure. Okay, so like that, for example, if you take set of students in a class. Okay, so whenever you are considering a students, some students will occupy rule number wise, or else some students will occupy as per the name of the student which is followed, which is following some alphabetical order. Okay, okay, A, B, C, the names starts from A, B, C, like that. Okay, and some students may be occupied that particular seats in a class as per their requirement. Is nothing but that is a random. Okay, how they are occupying is nothing but everywhere we can say that particular information or data is organized a specific manner. Okay, so that is nothing but data structure. Okay, so that's why we can define a data structure is a collection of data and it is going to be organized the data in a specific manner. Is nothing but organizing a data in specific manner. Okay, our data is organized in a specific structure. Okay, so as per our convenience we can able to say about the data structure definition, but before talking about the data structure, let us have a discussion about what do you mean by an algorithm. Okay, because you are organizing the data is nothing but step by step you have to keep. For example, just now I said we are placing a books in your room one after another. Is nothing but, for example, you are taking some C programming and data structure programming books, Java programming books. Okay, whenever you are taking all the books which are related to C programming, you have to keep in a particular cupboard in your room. Okay, is nothing but first of all what you have to take, you have to arrange all the items which are relevant to a specific type. Okay, so like that we can able to say this particular information has to be organized in a specific type or specific manner. So that's why I have given this particular data structure definition. Okay, in this case, first of all, step by step process we are applying is nothing but we have to say that is nothing but algorithm. Okay, so what we are trying to do by using this algorithm, we are specifying some finite number of steps to solve a particular task. Okay, and whenever we are talking about the algorithm, okay, let me write first of all algorithm. Okay, so whenever we are talking about the algorithm, and algorithms also must have its specifications. Specifications. Okay, now first of all, what do you mean by algorithm? Algorithm is nothing but it is a step by step process which is having finite number of instructions to solve a given problem.
Okay, so that is nothing but algorithm. Then you may have a question, then how can we solve this particular problem? Okay, is nothing but you must apply some step by step, and whenever you are applying the algorithm, it must have some kind of set of steps we have to approach. What are the set of steps? What are the specific characteristics? That is nothing but specifications of an algorithm. Then here we can able to define algorithm is a step-by-step process which is having finite number of instructions to solve a particular task. That is nothing but algorithm. Okay, now what are the specifications? Also you can say characteristics of an algorithms. Okay, what are the characteristics or specification of algorithms? We will see now. Okay, let me tell you, in this case specifications. Or I can say another way, that is nothing but characteristics. Specifications or characteristics of an algorithm. Okay, now there is a first specification is every algorithm must have some inputs. Okay, that is nothing but first specification. Okay, this is the first step. Whenever we are trying to apply an algorithm to solve a particular problem. Okay, so second one is every algorithm must have some outputs. Okay, and third one is finiteness. Whenever we are taking that, we can say finiteness. Okay, and fourth one, definiteness. And last one, total five types of specifications or characteristics are used to specify this particular algorithm. So fifth one is last step is nothing but effectiveness. Okay, these are the five steps we are supposed to be used in this algorithm. Okay, first one is the inputs, second one is the outputs, and finiteness, definiteness, and effectiveness. These are the five different characteristics we are supposed to be apply for an algorithm. Now you may have a question, why do we require to use these particular characteristics of an algorithm? So in this case, whenever we are talking about this particular one, we will say that inputs. Every algorithm must have some input. For example, a simple example as per our academics, let us have an example. That is, for example, you want to perform an addition of a two numbers. Okay. So in this case, if you want to perform an addition of a two numbers, first of all, you are always prompting the user, enter the two numbers. Okay. Is nothing but enter the A value as well as enter the B value. Okay, so as a part of that, the user has to enter A and B values. Is nothing but input must be there. Okay, and sometimes the input may be given inside a program itself. Is nothing but you are already taking into A equal to 10 into B equal to 20, so that you can able to add these two values and you can store inside a C variable. You can print that particular C value. So in the first case is nothing but you are prompting the user enter A and B value. Is nothing but at runtime you are prompting the user for an input. Is nothing but you must give at least one or more number of inputs. In the second case, static is nothing but in the program itself input already present. Okay, is nothing but you no need to give the inputs every time. Automatically inputs already taken by that particular program itself. So outcome you need to expect. So in this case, whenever we are talking about the static related applications, okay, their input is not required to specify at runtime. Is nothing but I can specify inputs are zero or more number of quantities. More quantities. Okay, what do you mean by zero? Zero is nothing but whenever your application is having some static nature, okay, whenever your application is having some static nature. And more quantities, whenever you are talking about the more quantities, whenever you are prompting the user for the inputs at runtime, okay, whenever you are prompting the user at runtime, then you can say that is more quantities. Okay, so this is, you can say, input. Okay, so in this case, what we are trying to say, whenever you are talking about the input, minimum zero quantities, maximum more than one. Okay, one or any number of quantities you can say. But whenever we are talking about zero quantities, is nothing but that is not the meaning of we are not giving any inputs. Simply, we have to consider the inputs already present in the program itself. Okay, so that's why I have specified here zero. Zero means that particular inputs already present inside a program itself. And more quantities is nothing but at runtime the user must give some inputs. Okay, so that's why input quantities always vary zero or more number of quantities. Okay, so this is one particular characteristic with respect to an algorithm. Okay, so now we will talk about output. Okay, what do you mean by an output? Is nothing but in our regular life, whenever you are executing any particular program, of course you are performing some task, you are always expecting some output. Okay, then output is compulsory. Whether you are performing a task, whether you are executing a program, whether you are running a big application or software, output is compulsory, you have to be expected. Okay, so in this case, minimum one output, maximum any number of outputs is nothing but one output is nothing but, let me take for the static input, if I am running 100 number of times, outcome always one type only. Okay, so that's why I can say one. Or more quantities is nothing but at runtime, if I am giving different values for the different inputs, okay, so I can able to get more than one type of outputs. Okay, so that is, I can say one or more, one or more outputs. Okay, so in this case, what we are trying to say is, whenever you are taking the static applications, okay, for the static application, one output. Okay, for runtime applications, we can take more outputs. Because runtime is, you are prompting the user, please enter a particular value for A as well as B. Is nothing but different times the user may enter different values. Okay, so that's why as per the user given, accordingly outcome will be changes. So that's why I have given more outputs in this case. Okay, so this is nothing but first case is input, second case is output. Both are completed. And next one is finiteness. Very important point is finiteness. Is nothing but in our regular life, we used to do so many different tasks. Of course, from the morning to till end of the day, we have to do so many tasks, and every task if you want to perform, you have to apply some step-by-step process. Okay, and these step-by-step process must be finite. It is nothing but set of number of steps which you are applying to solve a problem must be finite number. Is nothing but it must have a particular set of steps, must be countable. Okay, countable number of steps is nothing but every algorithm, it must have the number of steps must be countable. Okay, what we can say in this case, finiteness is nothing but number of steps must be finite, or I can say countable. Okay, so the number of steps must be finite or countable. That is nothing but finiteness. This is also one more considerable characteristics with respect to algorithm. Okay, and next one is definiteness. What do you mean by definiteness? Is nothing but whenever I am applying some set of steps, the steps must be unambiguous. Unambiguous is nothing but without confusion, your steps must be represented. Is nothing but every algorithm must have set of steps the steps must be countable or finite, as well as without confusion is nothing but without having ambiguity is nothing but every steps must be clear and unambiguous, you can say. Okay, is nothing but what we can say in this case, every step of an application must be clear. Okay, this is we can say. Okay, and next one is effectiveness. Okay, so effectiveness also you can say that here the effectiveness also represented every step must be clear as well as some kind of easiest manner we have to specify. This is an effectiveness of an algorithm. Okay, so these are the five characteristics we're supposed to be take: inputs, outputs, finiteness, definiteness, effectiveness. Okay, is nothing but feasible number of solutions we have to take for this particular effectiveness. Effectiveness is nothing but we can say feasible steps. Okay, all the steps must be feasible as well as clear. Okay, this is the major characteristics of an algorithm, as well as what are the characteristics or specification we need to apply in order to solve a particular problem. Okay, this is an introduction part of algorithm and its specifications. Okay.